Okay, Sky here with Sky Mangan Do. And today I've put together a emergency storm mooring for my daughter's yacht. It's hurricane season, so I just want to give you an idea. The vessel is in about 50 feet of water, and she's been, every little squall that passes, she's been moving her anchor. So this is our storm anchor. And it starts here with a big anchor that has the lead section inside of it for extra weight. Off of the shank of this anchor, we have a chain going back about 12 feet to a very old anchor that weighs about 60 pounds. That is just a trailing anchor. It's just meant to keep this down. On the other end of the anchor, we have a shackle. And if you can see here, we mouse all our shackles. In my experience in commercial diving and offshore work, we've had to recover a lot of equipment and vessels that shackles in rough seas, the shackle back out and let loose, and either equipment goes or the vessel goes. So that's the trailing anchor. The chain coming all the way back to the shank. Then we have the main chain, just to give you an idea of chain. This chain is a lot of overkill. We really want the weight. Her yacht usually uses about this size chain. I just have this piece here to show you. So this is about 50 to 55 feet of chain. And then it comes to a shackle here. It's terminated with a shackle, which I am going to mouse this onto a swivel, onto a chain swivel. And then the rope will go to the other end of the swivel. And if you notice, same way we have the wire left here to mouse off the chain, we have left a little tag line here so that we can also tie off our bowline, the tag end of the bowline when completed. So as we leave the chain, we're going to go to possibly another 50 feet of rope, which is what will come into the vessel. As you can see here, this is to prevent chafing where the rope comes onto the vessel on the gunwale. And same thing, our little tag line will tie off this into place to keep it where we want it. This then goes into this buoy. This buoy is the buoy that will mark when we put down the mooring and we go back to pick it up to pull it onto the boat. So this is just also just slack here, because when we eventually tie it on the boat, if there's any ends, we'll use this here again as the tag line. So this would be floating in the water when we set the anchor mooring, the storm mooring. And this here is just a trailer float that comes to this bottle, so that two things. One, when we come with a boat hook to pick it up, the boat hook hooks there and we can pull it on before we get to the strain of this, which would have the chain weight and all of that on it. And also, if there is a current running and the current takes down this a bit, the bottle will still be floating as a buoy, so that you can see it and work it back from there. Some of the tools we're using, the pipe wrenches, stainless steel wire to mouse out stuff, pliers and nippers, always have a knife. And we have some other odds and ends, hacksaw to get it done. But this is the storm mooring. This is hurricane time in the Caribbean.